So in the previous class, I have discussed the solutions for the assignment in general circular motion from question number 31 to 38. Now in this class, I am going to discuss the solutions of the remaining questions in the assignment in general circular motion. Come on, look at the question number 39 on the screen. Ball is suspended by a thread of length L from a point A. At the lowest position, it is given a velocity root 22 GL by 5 in the horizontal direction. The string slackens after swinging through an angle of dash with a vertical. So the problem can be solved by two methods. One method is by using the ready-made formula which I have discussed earlier. In case you remember the conclusion. The other method is without making use of the conclusion, starting from the basic equations which you studied in theory part. So here the bob of simple pendulum moves in the arc of a circle in the vertical plane with the point of suspension at center of the circular path. Let theta denote the angle made by the string with the downward vertical at the instant when the tension on the string becomes zero. And h denote the vertical height through which the bob rises above the lowest position at the instant when the tension on the string becomes zero. Here the value of u is given to be, u represent the magnitude of the initial velocity given to the bob at the lowest position in the oriented direction. So here the value of u is less than root 5 GL and u is greater than root 2 GL. So this problem comes under one of special cases I have discussed, motion of vertical circle. If u is less than root 5 GL but greater than root 2 GL, then the vertical height above the lowest position at which the tension of the string becomes 0 is given by u square plus GL by 3G. Here u square we can write 22 GL by 5. This you can try to simplify to yourself and find the value of H. Try to simplify it yourself. To simplify H, you will get 27 GL by 15 G or 9 L by 5. H can be written as L into 1 minus cos theta, as I discussed in the past. So H equal to here 9 L by 5. If you want to copy the solution of the problem, you can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem and complete the simplification part yourself. So if you simplify, you will get cos theta equal to minus 4 by 5. The value of cos 53 degrees is 3 by 5. The value of cos 53 degrees and cos 37 degrees. The value of cos 37 degrees, usually take it as nearly to be equal to 4 by 5. That means cos theta equal to minus cos 37 degrees. Cos theta is negative, means theta is greater than 90 degrees. There is one formula in elementary trigonometry which you discussed once in the past in vectors also. Cos 180 degrees minus theta equal to minus cos theta. So minus cos 37 degrees you can write cos of 180 minus 37 degrees. So you get cos theta equal to cos of 180 minus 37, or theta equal to 180 degrees minus 37 degrees. that cos theta is a theta equal to 143 degrees is the answer. You can also solve this problem by the alternate method. This alternate method I have discussed in one of the problems in the previous class. You can follow that same method here. In one of the problems which I have discussed in the previous class, I have calculated the vertical height h above the lowest position at which the tension in the string becomes 0, where we got the answer as 4L by 3. If you want to copy the solution, you can take a pause and copy the solution. So for question number 39, which I have just now discussed, third option is answer. You can follow the alternate method. If for question number 39, the alternate method, I don't want to repeat, I have already discussed the same method in the question number 34. So whatever alternate method I have discussed for question number 34, same alternate method can also be used even for this problem. I suggest the students to solve the same problem by the alternate method which I have discussed for question number 34. So look at the question number 40 here. A mass of 3.9 kg suspended from a string of length 0.5 meter is at rest. Another body of mass 0.1 kg moving horizontally with a velocity 200 meter per second strikes to it. The tension in the string when it makes 60 degrees with upward vertical is. I have discussed similar problem in the earlier class, but in that problem I ask you to find the magnitude of tension in the string at the instant when the string makes 60 degrees with the downward vertical. Here it is given as upward vertical. So there is a difference. To find the magnitude of tension in the string at that particular instant, where the string makes 60 degrees with upward vertical, you have to find magnitude of velocity of the mass at that instant. First, we'll apply conservation of energy principle. The initial momentum of system before collision is equal to momentum of the 0.1 kg mass, that is 0.1 kg into 200 meter per second. Total mass of the combined body after collision is equal to 3.9 plus 0.1 kg or 4 kg. So momentum just after collision, you can write 4 kg into magnitude of velocity just after collision. If you simplify this, you get v equal 5 meter per second. This can be taken as the initial velocity for motion after collision. This you can take it as the initial velocity of the combined mass for motion after the collision at the lowest position. So to find the magnitude of the tension in the string at the particular instant when the string makes an angle of 60 degrees with the upward vertical. Let V be the magnitude of velocity at that instant. And you take U as (5 meters per second). So for motion after collision, the initial velocity of the combined mass at the lowest position is 5 meters per second. There are two ways you can find the value of V from conservative energy. You can write V square equal to U square minus 2GH. You can find H in two different ways. One method is to use the result which we discussed in the past. So the angle which the string makes is downward vertical will be equal to 180 minus 60 or 120 degrees. So H can be found by two methods. One method is using that formula L into 1 minus cos theta. here theta is 120 degrees. Cos 120 degrees you can write minus half. So you get h equal to 3l by 2. You can also find h another way. You can first find the vertical height above the point of suspension at which the string makes an angle of 60 with upward vertical. That means we have a right angle triangle here, h1, l and 60 degrees. Length of side adjacent to 60 degrees is h1 and this is l. So h1 by l can write cos 60 degrees. So h1 you get l cos 60 degrees or l by 2. So h can be written as h plus h1. That is L by 2 plus L or 3L by 2, you can arrive at same conclusion. To find magnitude of velocity at that instant, use this equation which is obtained from conservative energy. V square U square U equal to 5 meter per second. H equal to 3L by 2, here L is given to be 0.5 meter. So u square minus 2gh, u square equal to u is equal to 5 meter per second. g is 10 meter per second square. H equal to 3l by 2, that comes out to 1.5 by 2 meter. So you get 25 minus 15. Meter square per second square or 10 meter per square per second square. So at the instant shown in the figure, the string makes an angle of 60 degrees with upward vertical. The weight mg acts vertically downwards. The tension force by the string acts along the string towards point of suspension or center of circular path. You can resolve the weight mg into components. The component mg cos 60 degrees act towards center. Draw a separate diagram again showing the components of weight mg. The component mg is sine 60 degrees act tangential to the path. So both the tension in the string and the component mg cos 60 degrees act towards center of circular path. So magnitude of centripetal force at the instant string makes 60 degrees upward vertical t plus mg cos theta. Here theta is 60 degrees. That is, you can write mv square where r equal to length of string. Now you can substitute v square equal to 10 on the right side. M equal to 4 kg and g equal to 10 meter per second square, cos 61 by 2. Come on, copy down the solution of the problem and complete the simplification part yourself. So if you simplify this, you get magnitude of tension in the string is equal to 60 into 10. Of course, you can also find magnitude of tension in the string by using the general equation which I have given for motion of vertical circle for calculation of the centripetal force and tension of the string. We can use the equation T minus mg cos theta equal to mv square by r. You can also use this equation to find magnitude of tension of the string. But here theta if you take 120 degrees, you get the same answer. So for question number 40, second option is the answer. Next you see the question number 41. simple pendulum has a string of length L and bob of mass M, and the bob is at the lowest position. It is given the minimum horizontal speed necessary to move it in a circular path about the point of suspension. The tension on the string at the lowest position of the bob is. So the bob can complete a vertical circle with a point of suspension at center of circular path. The maximum velocity at the highest position is equal to root gr or root gl, which is possible if the maximum initial velocity given at the lowest position is equal to root gl, root phi gl. This value of v2 we got by assuming that taking t2 equal to 0, that is tension in the string at the highest position. I mean, in the derivation which I discussed in the past, to find the same derivation you have in board exam also in 11th class or intermediate first year. To find the magnitude of the minimum velocity or minimum speed which the bob should have at the highest position to complete a vertical circle, you take magnitude of tension of the string at the highest position to 0. I am trying to solve this problem first by the easier method. So the bob of the simple pendulum rotates in the vertical circular path continuously, so that its total mechanical energy is constant. Then magnitude of the tension of the string at the lowest position minus magnitude of the tension of the string at the highest position is equal to 6 times the magnitude of the weight of the bob. If you take T2 equal to 0, you get T1 equal to 6 mg. You can also arrive at the same conclusion by the alternate method. So at the lowest position, the tension force by the string of the bob acts towards center of circular path. The weight mg acts away from center of circular path. So magnitude of the centripetal force of the bob at the lowest position is equal to T minus mg. That you can write mv square by r. So magnitude of the velocity at the lowest position to just complete a vertical circle is root phi gr. So you get T minus mg equal to 5 mg. So therefore magnitude of the tension in the string at the lowest position can write mg plus 5 mg or 6 mg. So if you want to copy this working, you can take a pause and copy the working. So for the question number 41, which I have just now discussed, fourth option is the answer. See the next question, 42, which is linked with the previous question. When the previous question, when the string is horizontal, the net force on the bob is. Here the bob at the lowest position is given the minimum initial velocity, which is just needed to complete a vertical circle. That means magnitude of the initial velocity at the lowest position, you can take root phi gr or root phi gl. In this case, radius of circular path is same as the length of the string. So at the instant when the bob and the string is horizontal, let me denote the magnitude of velocity. The height above the lowest position will be equal to L. Applying conservative energy, you can write total mechanical energy of the bob in the horizontal position is equal to total mechanical of the bob at the lowest position. So you get V square equal to U square minus 2gh, and U square here, U is root 5gl, and at the instant when the string is horizontal, h can be taken as equal to L. So you get V square equal to 5gl minus 2gl, or V square equal to 3gl. Let T denote the magnitude, tension force by the string on the bob. which acts along the string and towards center of circular path. The point center of circular path coincides with the point of center. That means only two forces act on the bob at any instant during the motion. One is the tension force by the string of the bob, which acts along the string and towards center of curvature of circular path. The weight mg acts vertically downwards. So at the instant when string is horizontal, the magnitude of the tension in the string is called mv square by r. Magnitude of centripetal force is same as E. Magnitude of tension in the string. Or even if you use the general equation T minus mg cos theta equal mv square by r. Here theta is 90 degrees when the string is horizontal. Theta is the angle made by string with the downward vertical. So cos theta becomes 0. So T equal to mv square by r. V square you can write 3gl. And radius circular path the length of string. So magnitude of tension on the string at the instant when the string is oriented with 3 mg. So here at the instant when the string is oriented, the two forces acting on the bob are perpendicular to each other. So magnitude of the net force on the bob at the particular instant when the string is oriented will be the resultant magnitude of the resultant of T and mg. Under root of T square plus mg square. As you studied in vectors, a vector A bar is perpendicular to vector B bar. Magnitude of the resultant of A bar and B bar is root of A square plus B square. Here magnitude of tension in the string equal to 3 mg. So this you can copy down. If you want to copy the solution of the problem, you can take a pause and copy the solution of the problem and complete the simplification. So if you complete the simplification, you will get mg into root 10. That's the answer. So for question number 42, which I have just now discussed, third option is the answer. Then see the next question, question number 43, which is given in the original IIT paper in 2013 exam. But the problem is not very difficult. It is simpler than some of the questions which you already discussed. You can see here bob of mass M suspended by string of length L1 is given a minimum velocity required to complete full circle in the vertical plane. At the highest point, it collides elastically with another bob of mass M suspended by a string of length L2 which is initial at rest. Both the strings are massless and inextensible. The second bob after the collision acquires the minimum speed required to complete a vertical full circle in the vertical plane. So here the magnitude of the velocity of the bob when it reaches the highest position the first bob is suspended string of length L. So when it reaches the highest position, it is given that the bob is given the minimum initial velocity required to just complete a vertical circle. That means the magnitude of velocity at the lowest position is root 5 gr. And magnitude of the velocity at the highest position is root gr or root gl. So magnitude of the velocity at the highest position just before it collides with the second bob, second particle, will be equal to root of gr r equal L1 here. As I discussed earlier in the theory of elastic one-dimensional collisions, in a one-dimensional collision, if the two colliding bodies have same mass, then their velocities will be interchanged after the collision. We write V1 equal to U2 and V2 equal to U1. The second body is initially at rest before the collision, and the two bodies have same mass. Collision is one dimensional elastic. Then after collision, the velocity of the first body becomes zero, and velocity of second body becomes equal to initial velocity of first body. That means the second bob, which is initially at rest at the highest position, gains the same velocity equal to root gl1. But the second bob is suspended by a string of length L2. I try to draw the figure in a little better way. The first bob is suspended by string of length L1. So it collides with second bob, which is initial at rest and suspended by string of length L2. After collision, just before collision, velocity of the first bob is equal to root g L1, because the minimum velocity at the highest position to complete a vertical circle is root g r, that is equal to root g L1 in the first case. So the velocity of second bob just after collision becomes same as the velocity of the first bob just before collision, because the velocities are interchanged after collision. So after the collision, the second bob starts moving with velocity of magnitude V2, and it is given that the second bob acquires the minimum velocity needed to just complete a vertical circle. That means V2, the last second bob at the lowest position in its circular path with radius L2, is equal to root 5g r, r2, radius of second circle. So V2 is same as U1 here, that is root gl1. R2 equal to L2. So if you simplify this, you get L1 equal to 5L2, or L1 by L2 is 5. So after the collision of the first bob with second bob, first bob, last the first bob becomes zero. That means after the collision, first bob falls free. The second bob starts with velocity of magnitude V2, which is equal to root GL1. According to the problem, the second bob gains a velocity which is exactly equal to the minimum speed required, minimum velocity required to complete a vertical circle, which is equal to root 5 GR. R in the second case is L2. If you want to copy the working, you can take a pause and copy the working. So for question number 43, first option is the answer. Then you see the next question. The next two questions are also given in the same paper. You might have gone through the problem earlier. I have shown you these questions. Small block of mass 1 kg released from rest at the top of a rough track. The track is a circular arc of radius (40 meters). The block slides along the track without toppling, and a frictional force acts on it in the direction opposite to the instantaneous velocity. The work line overcoming the friction up to the point Q is 150 joules, as shown in the figure. Below is, you have to take G equal to 10 meter per second. So let us look at the questions that are given there. This is the figure. Let us write the information given there. The mass M of the body is equal to 1 kg. The radius of circular path equal to 40 meter. So here the work line is overcoming friction as it moves from this position to this position at Q is 150 joules. So let us apply conservation of energy principle to find the value of V at this position Q. Let us see the question. In the speed, you are asked to find speed of the block when it reaches the point Q. So total, we choose the lowest position of the block as the reference position, suppose, for a measurement of gravitational potential. So initial height above the lowest position is equal to radius of the track. So this distance you can find here, this vertical distance you can suppose call this as Y1, otherwise that is the radius of track in this right angle triangle. You can observe Y1 by R equal to sine 30 degrees. Sine 30 degrees opposite side by adjacent hypotenuse side. So Y1 equal to R sine 30 degrees is 1 by 2. Let H2 be the new height above the lowest position. That you can write, H2 can be written as R minus Y1 or R minus R by 2. That means the height of the block above the lowest position when it reaches the position Q is R by 2. Total initial mechanical of the block at the initial position will be denoted by E subscript I. That is called kinetic energy plus potential. The kinetic energy you can take it as 0. Potential energy is equal to mg h1. That you can write h1 equal to r. Let EF denote the final mechanical of the bob at the position q. That is called kinetic energy of the block at the position q plus potential of the block at the position q. Potential energy of the block at the position q is mg h2. Here H2 you can write R by 2. Work done in overcoming friction is 150 joules. That means work done by friction force on the block will be negative because the friction force continuously acts opposite the instantaneous velocity. That you can take minus 150 joules. There is one principle which I discussed in the past in work power energy. If a single non-conservative force, that is frictional force, acts on the body, but other forces acting on the body are conservative, then the change in the total mechanical energy of the block is equal to work done by the friction force on the block. So here, initial mechanical of the block can be calculated because M is given, G is given to be 10 meter per second square, R is given to 40 meters. So that is 40 joules. Substituting here, EF equal to EI plus WF. EI is what is also here, work done by friction for the block is minus 50 joules. So total final mechanics of the block when it reaches the position Q will be I plus WF. That WF, that it comes out to be minus 110 joules. You can substitute EF equal to this value, half mv square plus mg r by 2. That is equal to EF here, same equation I am again writing. Now substitute all the values, m equal to 1 kg here. All values are understood to be in SI system. G 10 meter per second square, r is 40 meter. EF equal to minus 110. So change in the total mechanical for motion of the block up to the point Q. The change in the total mechanical of the block is equal to work done by the friction force on the block. Total final mechanical block at the position Q, as I discussed before, is equal to half mv square plus mg into r by 2. Total initial mechanical block at the starting position is equal to mgr. So you get half mv square equal to work done by the friction. Simplify this further. You get mgr by 2. This part simplification do it. So you are given the mass m as 1 kg here. Work done by friction force of block can take minus 50 joules. Work done by friction force of block will be negative because friction force of block acts opposite to the instantaneous velocity. The mass of block is 1 kg, g is 10 meter per second square, r equal to 40 meters. So mgr by 2 will be in joules. So you get v square equal to 50 meter square per second square. That is half v square. So you get v square equal to 100 meter square per second square. So v you get 10 meter per second. That is the answer. So if you want to copy the working, you can take a path and copy the working. So for question number 44, second option is the answer. See the next question, that is the last question in the assignment. The previous question, the magnitude of the normal reaction that acts on the block at the point Q is. So at this point Q, the radius of curvature of the circular path makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. So let us consider the force of 8 mg acts vertically downwards. The normal reaction force acts normal to surface of the track and directed away from surface. That means towards center of curvature of circular path. So the angle which the radius makes with the vertical, the radius of the circular path makes with the vertical at this position Q. That means the radius of the circular path or radius of curvature of the track passing through the point Q makes an angle of 60 degrees with the vertical. 90 minus 30 is equal to 60. So this will be also equal to 60 degrees. So the normal reaction force act towards center of curvature of circular path. To find magnitude of the net force towards center of curvature means centripetal force, you can resolve the weight mg into rectangular components along the radius of curvature of circular path and tangential to the radius of curvature of circular path. The component mg cos 60 degrees acts along the radius of curvature of circular path opposite to normal reaction. The component mg sin 60 degrees act tangential to circular path. Of course, there will be also frictional force which act tangential to the path. The friction force will have no component along the radial direction. So the friction force acts in the tangential direction. That means at the position Q, the magnitude of centripetal force on the body is equal to n minus mg cos 60 degrees. So you can write equal to mv square by r. So magnitude of the normal reaction force in the body by the smooth circular track is equal to mg cos 60 degrees plus mv square by r. Here the mass m is given to 1 kg, g 10 meter per second square, cos 60 degrees equal to 1. Radius of circular path is 40 meters. V is equal to 10 meter per second. We have expressed all units in SI system. So you can simplify this further. So the magnitude of the normal reaction force at the position Q will get 7.5 Newton. If you want to copy the working, you can take a pause and copy the working. So for question number 45, first option is answer. So with this, I have completed discussion of the solutions for the questions in assignment in general circular motion up to 145th question. In case you are unable to solve most of these questions in the first trial, need not get discouraged. You can go through all the solutions first. After going through all the solutions, you can make a fresh start. That means after going through all the solutions, you can take a gap and again you start going through the assignment freshly and again try all the questions in the assignment from 31 to 45 in the same order. So that finally you should be able to solve those models or problems. So I will continue in my next class here.